disappear. I was aching to be somewhere near. Your voice was all I heard. I was shaking from a storm in me, haunted by the specters that we had to see. Yeah, I wanted to be the melody above the noise, above the hurt. I was young, not dumb, just wishing to be blinded by you, brand new. And we were pilgrims on our way. I woke up at the moment when the miracle occurred. Heard a song that made some sense out of the world.
SW, and I know it's been a while, and I've just finally actually gotten enough time to like really heavily record stuff other than Poke Battle and Pokemon Showdown for Istari Gaming, and so I thought I might as well come back to the Let's Play series, and this time while I do some stuff that I would usually do off camera, which is started a second part of this mine that's going down this way instead of this way like that one did. I'm actually just going to be laying some stairs down and then actually just strip mining for the rest of this, and then I'm going to be talking over this because I have a lot of things to talk about right now. And yeah, so the first thing that I want to talk about is I really want to apologize because in the middle of August, I didn't actually give the reason as to why I wasn't here, but the reason was actually that I had my internet down for a few days. If you've ever heard in the background of my videos, people tearing apart my house, that's because I'm having some people do housework, and, ooh, that's so ugly. Anyways, because of that, my internet actually had to go down for, like 2 weeks, I think it was, and it was just, really bad because I couldn't, I had to send my all my videos off to a friend of mine who could upload them onto the Atari gaming normal channel during the time that my internet would be down. And that was really unfortunate. And because of that, I did a lot of pre-recording. And because I did so much pre-recording, I actually pre-recorded some a bit more than I ended up needing to have uploaded, and because of that, I had like another 2 weeks worth of content done at the end of this whole thing. I guess that was also because I sort of didn't want to, what's it called, end up completely abandoning Minecraft while I could and recording and being able to upload. I mean, like, I know I could technically just run the program and play offline, but I can't. It's just annoying for me to not see my own skin, and so I think that was another factor in it. And because of this, okay. So, you might not realize this, but there's an artist that, for instance, makes the music that I use for all of my videos. And that's the artist that wrote the song at the start of this video, and the artist that, well, my favorite artist in general, and that is U2. They're an Irish rock band, and they're one of the most successful bands in history. I'm not going to go too in depth because I'm a complete U2 fan, and I could just spend days talking about how popular they've been. And honestly, the thing is that a new U2 album came out during the time when I had pre-recorded all that stuff for, what's it called? Well, during the time that I had pre-recorded, that I had stuff pre-recorded from before when my internet went down. So I couldn't. I just wanted to let my videos out at a constant, slowish rate so that stuff like that wouldn't happen. Well, not stuff like that, but just 'cause. And because of that, actually, what ended up happening was that I didn't get to talk about the album. At least now, though, I've actually listened to it a lot more than I did at first, and I can probably give a much better opinion about what I think of it. Yeah. So, first of all, I think it's a really underrated album. At least some of the later songs on it. I mean, one of the things about U2 is that often some of the best songs on the album can sometimes be some of the last tracks. Like some classic examples of this are like "Mysterious Ways" from Octon Baby, "One Tree Hill" on the Joshua Tree. What else is there? Well, there's a lot of them. "Bad," "Bad" from the Unforgettable Fire. There's another one. But basically, because of this, if you sort of listen to it, it sort of gets boring pretty quickly because I mean like, the first few songs are pretty good, but they're not like leaping out of you like U2 normally does. And so it's easy to lose the attention span when you're just listening to that. But like, there's like two songs on the second half of it that are just like completely, they just sound amazing. And those two tracks that I really think are the best tracks, even better than The Miracle of Joey Ramone, which is the first track that you listen to if you watched the fast forward part of this video. I think that the two best tracks on the album, including that one, are honestly Volcano and what's it called? This Is Where You Can Reach Me Now. They just completely set me on fire, like City of Blinding Lights, Beautiful Day, Where the Streets Have No Name, all sorts of other U2 hits. And it's just, they don't get very much publicity because they're at the back of the album. And yeah, so those are my main thoughts on the new U2 album. Also, U2 got a lot of hate because it automatically downloaded itself onto everyone's phones. But here is my thing, though. I'm the U2 fan, right? Well, it just so happens that I've had a few glitches with some other music, and it makes it so that Apple automatically downloads this one album that I also have a physical copy that I actually installed for myself, imported, that's the right phrase. And the thing is that it'll automatically download the version that I just bought off iTunes, which I bought on accident. And because of that, I turned off the setting which says automatically download music that you've bought. And the thing is that what Apple did was they technically didn't make it so that you would automatically automatically download the new album. They just paid for it for you. And because of that, despite everyone else saying, oh my gosh, I don't like this, and I didn't want to get this, and yeah, I didn't actually get the album until a few days later when I managed to work out myself how exactly to fix the problem that I had. And so it was just like, from my perspective, everyone was getting the album except me, and I was the only person who wanted it. So yeah, overall, I think it's one of their better works, like their best work from Action Baby, barring How to Dismantle an Atomic Bomb. Yeah, so I definitely recommend listening to it. Don't get daunted by, like, the first tracks, which are just, like, sort of calming. Like, I mean, I do like some of them, like, Every Breaking Wave's the only one I don't really like, but Songs for Someone and Iris I really like. But, like, on the second half, just Raised by Wolves, Volcano, This Is Where You Can Reach Me Now. If you're into, like, heavier rock, then, like, U2's actually a rock band, by the way, might as well mention that, then those are the songs to listen to. And looking at time, that's pretty much all I have. Didn't get much strip mining in, but we got a decent amount of iron, so yeah. Hope you guys have enjoyed my discussing my favorite music, and yeah, I'll see you guys next time.